50 miles, an epic and possibly once-in-a-lifetime journey across the Panama Canal, but of only 50 miles, has brought us to a new ocean.
There it is, the Pacific Ocean.
In the year 1520, explorer Ferdinand Magellan, after crossing the Atlantic in search of a new trade route to the Spice Islands, conquered Cape Horn and entered this new, unfamiliar ocean, naming it the Pacific, or the Peaceful Ocean. It is the largest ocean on Earth, taking up a whopping 60 million square miles, more than all of the continents combined. But for us, we have entered our first square mile, and it is hard to process how different this new ocean looks and feels. The sunsets are stunning over an endless horizon of open water. Huge tidal changes and long Pacific swell seem to be the breaths of this giant body of water, teeming with life above and below its surface. Even the Pelicans seem to have chosen this ocean, having not seen a single one on Panama's northern coast. The raccoons casually descend from the trees, taking to the streets like the little banditos they are. And the sloths take to highways of their own under the cover of darkness.
Oh yeah, does that feel good?
This new ocean also changes the dynamic of living on the water. The steep, underwater, cliff-like shelves, strong tidal currents, and big Pacific swells can make calm anchorages very rolly in the right or wrong conditions, making even the wide and more stable platform of a catamaran twist and roll violently at anchor.
Definitely in the next couple days we're gonna be getting out of here. I am moving right now to stop myself from like thrashing around. It's like my body has to move to compensate like we're sailing.
This new chapter was off to a rocky start. With computer work always beckoning, Katie took to the floor of the cabin to avoid the worst parts of the constant motion for Zoom calls.
You didn't sleep and we were at the dock last night because of all the noise from the lines on the dock creaking.
So loud. Mm-hmm. Like so, like really, really loud. I had earplugs in and my noise canceling headphones on top of it with the noise canceling on high, and it was still like. That's an exact demonstration.
Oh, also, we're back out on anchor. We didn't film being back out on anchor. Literally, I could throw a stone to the marina right now. We just wanted to get out of there. They charge an arm and a leg. It was $200 for two nights there. So we got off the dock this morning and came out here and anchored. And honestly, there's so much surge that gets into the anchor or the marina anyway, that the boat being tied to the dock was like thrashing around. And even though it's bumpy and windy and there's a lot of stuff going on, Katie and I are very, very excited to be living on anchor again.
That was way more adventurous than it should have been.
Yeah. That was a day and a half of work right there.
You get bonus hours for when it's really rolling.
Oh man, this is what we gotta do. This is paying our dues, really, you know? We live this lifestyle. Yeah, I don't mind it either.
I don't mind it when I'm not feeling like a trash can.
Yeah, Katie didn't feel good today. She slept most of the day. No fever or anything like that, nothing else. Just kind of like maybe run down from the couple of days of traveling on the Panama Canal and all the crazy work we've done to get ready for it. Anyway, we're gonna enjoy some sundowners, which are really just some OJ and greens mixture, greens powder.
At night, we danced around trying to find the best sleeping spots, thankful for all the different beds on Boundless.
Little Bum likes to make little nests. And this is the best version yet, huh?
This is the best nest yet.
After coffee and breakfast, we launched the dinghy in 20 knots of wind. Told Boundless not to go anywhere while we sought some reprieve from the rolling and some groceries.
Hey, Boundless, you be good.
Our taxi took us past a beautiful view of Panama City and the northern anchorage, the other choice we had but more exposed to the current conditions, and to a store that just happened to be on the outskirts of one of the most beautiful places called Old Town Panama. So sometimes a grocery run turns into something entirely different.
Look at this. I know, I have it on the camera. This is beautiful.
Completely empty stomachs. And we decided to
So this has never happened on sailing Seawind. But we went to a hair salon and got drunk. So we're in Panama City. Actually, we're in Old Town. And
I'm gonna look at my phone.
And we came here because, oh, yes, and the purse. Thank you so much. Yes, is mine. Thank you very much. I just left my backpack there. Okay.
Let's just change.
I have my backpack now, and I'm going to put up a montage of all the beautiful photos of all the old architecture around here, and we're gonna get some food because we're very hungry. We just had dinner and we have our wits about us again. Honestly, you know, especially for Katie and I, we don't do this often, but it sure is nice to let our hair down a little bit, huh?
We had two drinks.
I know we had two drinks. We only had two drinks, okay? We're lightweights. We don't drink often, but like, I don't know. I feel like this made our experience here in Panama even more special. Like, see, look at this, like, old architecture here. Like, this is what we're walking through right now.
I think it was the city before the city.
Called Casco?
Casco.
Yeah, so this is Casco, which is called Old Town. And the architecture here and just the... You can just feel this old age from this place. Like all these churches, look at this. That's just gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. It just like, I don't know, speaks to you a little bit. I'm super glad that we stumbled upon this place. Very, very happy. Anyway, all right, we're gonna go back to our El Barco. Oh, look at here. Wow. Oreo.
From what we've heard of Panamanian history, they were invaded by the Spaniards. And so I think Old Town Panama was heavily influenced by Spanish architecture.
What's up, sweetie?
Our friend's here.
Who is it?
The sloth.
There he is again. Hi, Mr. Sloth. He's just hanging around.
I love so much that it just hangs around.
Yeah.
I wonder if
we're feeling the sloth vibes, that's for sure.
That's for
you have sloth vibes too, leave it down in the comments. We just went to get some eggs. Extreme egg getting. We've been talking lately about how everything on a boat can end up being extreme. Extreme teeth brushing. Extreme sleeping.
That's what it feels like every night. I'm like getting ready to go to battle.
We were just putting the dinghy up and there was this bird that came by, and there's quite a bit of wind right now still in the anchorage. And this bird just comes flying upwind along our starboard side of the boat, and it's like flying in place, stationary, right next to our boat. We have the spreader lights on and stuff. I think that's probably it was using the light to fish. And I was like, oh, I have to go get my camera. He did it like five or six times.
That's just a seagull.
It's a seagull?
Yeah.
Well, it's the coolest seagull in the world.
That was so cool. I can't believe that. It's just a seagull. But still, that interaction, or at least observing the bird, the animal, how amazing. Anyway, all right. We're gonna get some sleep or get cleaned up and read until we fall asleep anyway.
The boat is just bopping and bopping.
So when the previous owners installed the B&G equipment, they didn't take the mast out of the boat, so they didn't put the new wiring in the channel in the mast that holds the wires stationary. They just dropped the wires down from the top of the mast and, you know, fished them out through a hole in the bottom. This truly torturous kind of noise, especially in a rolly anchorage, happens. Good thing the in our aft cabin you can't hear it too much, in the V-berth you can't hear it too much, but sometimes in an anchorage like this anyway, it would be nice to be able to sleep on the settees because they are low and more centerline, so you just don't get as much movement. Plus the lee cloth, as you saw earlier, that really allows you to like wedge yourself in, especially when there's like unpredictable stuff. If it was just wraparound swell, we could do a stern anchor or a bridle or something, and then it's just that one consistent pattern of swell and up and down that you just deal with. And that's fine. Even an anchorage like this is fine. Like sleeping in a settee, no big deal. But the noise out here is just, it really is very annoying. I mean, the boat has so much interior woodwork and there's like not a creak to be heard. And Katie wears earplugs and she can still hear it. So the moral of the story is, at some point, probably in Mexico, we are going to take the mast out of the boat at a marina. It needs some work anyway on the paint and everything, and that's what we're gonna do. Mm-hmm. And we'll rewire it and definitely run the new cabling through the channel. La Playita Marina, La Playita Marina, this is sailing vessel Boundless, over. Good morning, we have an appointment at 9:30 for the fuel dock.
Yes, Boundless, good morning, the dock is available.
Okay, we are just coming into the entrance of the marina now, so we will see you there. Thank you. All right, that was wild. The anchor washdown just stopped. Didn't trip the breaker, didn't do anything. It just stopped working. And I didn't want to put like so much mud into the anchor locker, so we just hauled it up onto the deck manually. Good morning.
We are using our water separator and filter to fill the tanks because you can never be too sure that there isn't water in fuel. We did not do it in Shelter Bay because they seem to be pretty good there. They give you samples and stuff like that. And so anyway, we're using it here. I'm curious to see what comes up, if anything, at the bottom. The only tricky thing is you can't hear it coming up the neck with this. And so if I have a whole container full and it's full, then it would go all over the deck.
What a mess.
Okay, that epic is over.
Necessary,
yes.
But what?
Very happy about that. All right, let's get the hell out of here, huh?
All right, you're just gonna back straight.
Yeah, I'm just gonna back straight up.
All right.
This seemingly easy backing straight up could have.
We have to come
in. Yeah, I know. We go. We're good. Goodbye, Panama City. We're not sure if we'll be back to you, so
hopefully not.
Hopefully not. Hopefully we're going to go to Las Perlas, spend some time there, and head that way towards Mexico. So,
here we go.
We are out of here.
Just trying to get enough service to send off a message to my mom. I should have sent it sooner. I was saying that it's so ironic that today is the day we're leaving on a Friday. We don't have to work. And literally there's been like very, very minimal traffic in the channel. Like no pilot boats, not a lot of recreational boats. It's like, it was super pretty calm in the anchorage this morning. And of course we're not like, that's the day we're leaving, don't have to work. So I said, oh, the irony of life.
All right, let's go sailing. Woo! Shutting the engine off! Yeah. Alright. Woo! We got full sails out right now. Staysail for the first time. Let me show you guys. All right. Woo!
We are sailing. It feels so good. Oh my gosh. What a relief. Wow. We did it. We did it. Oh man, this feels so good. Am I rolling? I was just saying to Katie that I love traveling. I love seeing new places. I like snorkeling. I love being in anchorages. I love waking up to beautiful sunrises and sunsets in an anchorage or even at a dock. I love exploring islands and towns and cities, but I am truly happiest personally out here when we are sailing. It is hands down my happy place. I love it. We have two lines in the water. My love is resting on a settee. I'm just sitting here. There's no work. There's no outside things. We have no reception. Starlink is not on. We have the Iridium Go for the tracking and, you know, emergency communication. And it is just us. I could honestly go on through any challenge that the ocean would give us, I think indefinitely, honestly. I can't wait to cross an ocean with you.
Yeah.
How do you feel? What is your personal, what is your personal favorite?
Being outside.
Being outside.
Mm-hmm. Whether it's sailing or in the water or just waking up and being so close to being outside. I also like the smell of the air when we're on the sea. I like it all.
Yeah. You like everything about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cool. I love you, sweet pea.
Love you.
For doing it. Oh. Oh.
There was a bug or crab in my drink.
Oh gosh.
A bug.
What's that?
That's why I just spit it. Sorry.
I was getting a majestic shot of you taking a drink of water, and then all of a sudden you're like heaving.
I didn't heave, I just let it go.
Yeah. Dolphins!
Here comes.
Land ho! You see the Pearless Islands, the pearls. Alrighty, we are just nosing into our anchorage. I didn't expect there to be homes here. There are like lots and lots of villas. Pretty cool. Our first anchorage in Las Perlas, the Pearl Islands. Filming the night sky is something I love to do, although I am new to it, and it is very hard on a constantly moving boat. It was super calm this evening. You can see the picture changing as I try different settings to see what captures the most stars with the clearest picture. It sure is fun. Good morning. Katie and I just woke up. It is magical out here right now. Oh my gosh, there's fish jumping out there. It is like glass this morning. We slept so well. It's about 7 o'clock. Oh, what a beautiful night of sleep. Oh man, very grateful. Like royalty. All you had to do is come to Las Perlas.
That's it.
Oh, now she's sleeping again.
Right in here, skirt. Ooh. Is that it? I'm gonna get me some fishes.
I don't know, you're the wildlife narrator. You're the next David Attenborough.
Yeah.
Let me get up in here. Get a taste of these fish. Skirt, skirt.
Oh. Oh yeah. Oh. Oh.
Get it. Get it, you pelican.
Oh.
Wow.
Can't all get right. Enough.
He's like, I'm at my buffet.
My face is gonna fry off.
So we are running the water maker for the first time since I made the repairs to the plumbing. And I am here to report that it is running beautifully. So the output water from replacing that restriction that was just the plumbing off the Seacock, I showed you that before, and the new seawater strainer, and upsizing the hoses to the 3/4 inch inner diameter like they should have been. We have like almost double visibly out the side of the boat, almost, I think, at least a third more, if not 50% more brine water than we had before. And we are up from 10 to 12 gallons per hour to a steady 16 plus gallons an hour of fresh water that we are making. And because we have more feed pressure and more feed water volume, we are running at a lower PPM. So before we were at like around 500 or so, now we were at like 350, if not getting down to even lower than that. I haven't tested it, you know, since I switched the valve over to the tank, but we are rapidly filling our tanks, and it is wonderful, and it is completely powered by the solar that we have. So how cool is that? Powered by the sun, we are making fresh water from salt water and still charging on top of all that. So all of our refrigerators running, the fans, the water maker, we're charging things. We have the inverter running, we have Starlink on, and we are still charging the batteries. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I said it a few times, but I'll say it again. We did it. Sailing to the Pacific Ocean was a decision we made before either one of us knew it.
Change is hard, and chasing a dream like this has an endless supply of it. There is always grief that accompanies it, no matter how small or big the change. I think it's fitting to end this episode with our plaque gifted to us by our dear friends Terry and Jeannie, and what has been our motto since the very beginning. We have no plan and intend to stick to it. If you haven't yet, like this video and subscribe to our channel. We love reading what you have to say, so leave a comment as well. All of this interaction really helps our channel grow, and if you already are, and are wondering how to support our channel in a different way, head on over to patreon.com/sailingseawind. There you can support us for as little as $3 an episode, and gain access to things like our real-time tracking link, regular candid updates from us wherever we are, direct messaging, and early ad-free access to our weekly videos. You can even join for free at first to get a feel for the patron platform. Up next, we take you along with us as we set up and fly our spinnaker for the first time, sailing to another of the Pearl Islands, catching our first Pacific Ocean fish along the way. You won't want to miss it.